For us self-proclaimed technologically advanced creatures, humans of the past may appear terribly primitive in comparison to us. A massive technological gap nearly designates us as a new species, and it only took a few hundred years to do so. We believe that because human curiosity knows no bounds, neither does our intellectual progress. However, how advanced could the human race become, and how long will it take to become super advanced? Do great cosmic voids point to hyper-intelligent extraterrestrial life? And how far advanced would those alien civilizations be? Prepare to learn the answers to these questions and more. We've built the internet, landed on the moon, discovered the Higgs boson, and sent our spacecraft into interstellar space. It appears that we've accomplished more than we could ever imagine in the last 100 years, and it's difficult to imagine that we could go any further. But what if that's just the tip of the iceberg? What if all human progress is nothing more than our collective illusion over time? Over time, the Kardashev, a Type 1 civilization, or planetary civilization, would be capable of harvesting all of the energy resources available on its planet. A two-type civilization, or stellar civilization, would be capable of harnessing the energy of an entire star, effectively allowing it to control an entire planetary system. And a Type 3 civilization, or galactic civilization, would be capable of utilizing the energy resources of an entire galaxy, moving planets and feeding black holes with stars. But even that is a long way from what a Type 4 civilization would be capable of. And according to this scale, we haven't yet achieved Type 1 civilization status. But we're no longer a Type 0 civilization. So where does that leave us? On the Kardashev scale, 0 represents a specific amount of energy consumed by a civilization, which is roughly 1 megawatt of power. Our average annual energy consumption is currently around 17.7 terawatts. And a single terawatt would be enough to power 10 billion 100 watt light bulbs simultaneously. Humans have a score of about 0.73 on the Kardashev scale. But how quickly can we reach the milestone of Type 1 civilization? We'd be able to use all the sunlight, wind, and tides available to us once we achieved this status, according to one famous theoretical physicist. And we'd be able to alter the course of earthquakes and volcanoes if we increased energy consumption by 3% annually. Currently, about 1/1,000,000th of our star's energy reaches Earth, and we only use 1/1,000,000th of that. Once we achieved this status, we'd be able to use all of the sunlight. There are several ways to do it. One idea is to use a megastructure called a Dyson sphere. In its simplified version, a Dyson ring would consist of a bunch of solar power collectors encircling a star at a distance of, say, 160 million kilometers. And as this civilization advances its technology, it would add more rings around a star, each with its own orbit. Eventually, this megastructure, the size of our planet's orbit, aroused. A Type 3 civilization might be able to siphon material from a star and put it into the ergosphere of a spinning black hole. The ergosphere is a region surrounding a black hole outside its event horizon, where many fascinating phenomena occur. By sending material into this region around a black hole, you could get energy back out at much higher speeds. This is known as the Penrose process, and it can extract roughly 29% of the energy in a black hole. However, there is a drawback to this method. A black hole will start spinning slower and eventually stop. But it also opens up the possibility of harnessing Hawking radiation from evaporating black holes, which is far beyond our capabilities, but not rocket science for a Type 3 civilization. This galactic-level civilization would essentially use the same technology as the previous one, but on a much larger scale. Entire galaxies would be filled with Dyson spheres surrounding billions of stars. New planetary systems would be artificially created, and their energy supplies would be infinite. They would practically become immortal, and the only thing that would threaten their existence would be a sudden natural disaster, such as a massive ejection of the sun. A much more effective method would be to break signals in all frequencies in order to preserve the majority of the signal. Unfortunately, a hypothetical Type Zero civilization using only one frequency would be unable to read that message fully, instead of hearing nonsense. So even if the Milky Way is full of messages from Type 2 or Type 3 civilizations, human Type Zero radio telescopes will be unable to hear them properly. Another researcher at China's National Astronomical Observatory came up with a solution. Astronomers hope it will point to a slew of Dyson spheres and entire galaxies captured by an intelligent civilization, or civilizations. But they need to know for sure what's causing these infrared emissions to prove the theory. There's also another solution to the Fermi paradox. Perhaps these civilizations have chosen to remain unseen. When looking for signs of technologically advanced civilization, astronomers often base their observations on different types of infrared emissions and waste. But what if a super intelligent civilization has not only come up with unimaginable technologies, but has also found a way to hide its presence? If so, all this time, have we been searching for something we shouldn't be looking for? Instead, the most likely scenario is that if a Type 3 civilization existed somewhere out there, it would gather all of the energy available in a galaxy and exhaust all of its power supply, leaving nothing behind. And there are such empty regions in space, the great voids that were once thought to be signatures of intelligent life. But this theory was refuted. And while scientists haven't given up hope, most of their studies eventually come to a dead end. And if that's always the case, Type 2 civilizations would be concerned about how to avoid the death of their star, while Type 3 civilization would be concerned about how to avoid the death of the universe. However, if we look at the broader version of the Kardashev scale for a Type 4 or even Type 5 civilization, this would not be a concern because these creatures could theoretically form a new universe. And according to one physicist, the energy required to give birth to a baby universe in a laboratory would require about 1,000 trillion degrees, which is far below the limit of such a civilization. Although Type 4 civilization is unlikely to ever be achieved, it would literally mean becoming the creators of everything we could ever observe, think, or imagine. Given how quickly we evolve, and that even today the creation of effective tiny laser-propelled spacecraft is within our arm's reach, it is possible that we have already been visited in the past, and the odds of noticing their presence are extremely high. Until then,